The annual Christmas exodus as Filipinos make their way to their home provinces in time for the holidays. Let's get an update on the situation in Manila's main gateway from our correspondent Vivian Gulia. Viv, over to you. What can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Peak of the peak. That's how Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista described the expected volume of passengers here at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport today and tomorrow, the last 2 days before Christmas Eve. As of 12 noon today, as you can see, we are still seeing light to moderate traffic along the road in front of NAIA Terminal 3, but heavy traffic is expected this afternoon as workers end their last working day before Christmas. Inside the airport, we saw long lines of passengers at check-in and immigration counters. The entrance to immigration counters has also become a choke point as airport personnel scan a QR code from the ticket. Secretary Jaime Bautista says this is a system being piloted that seeks to identify the location of passengers who have checked in to aid in preventing flight delays. The Manila International Airport Authority saw a slight dip in the on-time performance of airlines operating at NAIA amid the holiday exodus from the 80% OTP recorded in the last 3 months. But MIAA OIC Brian Kahn notes that the number of flight delays remains at manageable levels. He attributes the decline in on-time performance to inclement weather condition, congestion, and the availability and operational readiness of aircraft. But MIA continues to coordinate with airlines to reduce delayed flights as we approach the peak of the peak season. Bautista says passenger volume at NAIA has reached around 140,000 yesterday, up from the usual daily average of 120,000 to 130,000. That figure is also an increase from the pre-pandemic levels. Transport officials expect passenger volume today and tomorrow to hit 140,000 to 145,000 passengers per day. Passengers are advised to arrive at the airport at least 2 hours ahead of their departure for domestic flights and at least 3 hours for international flights. To fast-track processing, they are encouraged to do online check-in, pay their travel taxes online, and for international passengers, accomplish their e-travel ahead of their flight. Meanwhile, Secretary Bautista welcomes the appointment of Eric Ines as Acting General Manager of the Manila International Airport Authority. He says Ines will take his oath and assume office next week. That's the latest from here. Carmina, back to you.
Okay, Viv, if I don't see you back here at HQ, Merry Christmas to you and your brood. Holiday travelers are also flocking to the Batangas Port. Dennis Datu is there with the latest. Dennis.
Yes, Carmina, in fact, passengers at Batangas Port continues as they travel back to their respective provinces to celebrate Christmas. At this time, according to the records of Philippine Ports Authority Batangas, the number of passengers has reached almost 8,000 since midnight and is expected to reach 30,000 outside the Batangas passenger terminal. PPA Batangas has placed chairs and tents for passengers to temporarily stay while waiting to enter the passenger terminal and purchase tickets. The line of passengers at the ticketing booth, especially for trips to Calapan City in the Oriental Mindoro, is also getting longer. Trips to Katiklan of Starlight and Togo shipping lines are fully booked, but there are still many walk-in passengers lining up to purchase tickets, hoping to become chance passengers. Marina Region 4 Public Information Officer Attorney Ivy Audrey Fampo said they have already sent an urgent request to shipping lines to deploy additional vessels on the Batangas-Katiklan route. They have also requested other regional offices to send ships. Since the ships to Katiklan are fully booked, PPA Batangas Port Manager Joselito Ciro Cruz advised passengers heading to Katiklan to take a trip to Calapan first and then board a trip to Katiklan from Bohas Port in Oriental Mindoro. Although there is a continuous influx of passengers at Batangas Port, there are still many seats available in the departure area as Phase 2 has been temporarily opened, accommodating an additional 2,000 passengers. For those bringing vehicles across Batangas Port, we prefer to endure a long line outside the port. it is expected that the increase in passengers at Batangas Port will continue until Christmas Eve. Additional security personnel from Port Police and Coast Guard have been deployed at Batangas Port, and help desks have also been set up to assist passengers. Fermina.
Right. Pero Dennis, may kumpiyansa naman yung mga otoridad na there will be enough trips, there will be enough vessels to ferry the passengers to their point of destination. Hindi naman mangyayari yung scenario na mayroong mga hindi makakapaglayag.
Carmina, sa ngayon ay meron pang mga barko na bumabiyahe patungo sa ibang ruta. Pero yung katiklan, yun ang problema dahil marami na yung mga pasahero na naririto. Katunayan, nung kahapon ay naghintay sila ng ilang oras para makasakay ng barko dahil hinintay pa nila na merong magkaroon ng available na barko, Carmina.
Oo, pero Dennis, itong mga pasaherong ito papuntang Katiklan, booked na yan or chance passengers lamang sila?
Okay. Ito ay online, nag-book online. Mm. Pero merong mga dumarating pa dito marami na walk-in. So yun ang hinihintay nila na magkaroon ng pagkakatao. Kung may mga hindi sumipot na online, na nakabook online, doon lamang sila nagkakaroon ng pagkakataon na maisakay. Yung request ng Marina doon sa ibang mga barko, actually pitong shipping lines na request sa Marina na magdagdag ng mga karagdagang barko, pero hindi din makapagpadala dahil iba daw yung classification ng mga barko kapag malalayo yung mga biyahe, Carmina.
Mm-mm. Ito ba'y ganito parate tuwing Kapaskuhan o ngayon lamang ito nangyari?
Ngayon lamang ito. Nung nagdaang Holy Week ay naging maayos naman, Carmina.
Okay, we're going to have to look into that. In the meantime, Dennis Dato there joining us on the line. Dennis, Merry Christmas to you. And let's go over now to the Manila North Harbor Port, where an influx of passengers is expected due to the Christmas rush. Our very own Victoria Tulad there with an update. Victoria, over to you.
Carmina, the Philippine Ports Authority, or PPA, expects the peak of passengers traveling for Christmas at various seaports today. PPA spokesperson Eunice Samonte said this number might reach up to 300,000. One of those waiting to board a ship at the Manila North Port passenger terminal is Rico Entia, who was recently released from jail. He is bound for Cebu but was not able to buy a ticket, with trips all sold out. Like Rico, Rodelia Waskin, who is going to Misamis Occidental, fears she won't make it for Christmas after her trip got rescheduled. According to PPA, trips were suspended and moved to a later date due to Typhoon Kabayan. Because of this, passengers who were already at the Manila North Port were forced to sleep on the floor with only a piece of carton as their mat. They said they couldn't go home since they didn't want to spend again on fare. Samonte advised passengers to check with their shipping lines first on the status of their trip before going to the port. She also reminded shipping companies to give prompt alerts to their customers. Trips have resumed today here at the Manila port, which is also why there are more passengers at the moment. Samonte reminded passengers to travel light and not bring prohibited materials such as sharp objects or flammable materials. She said those who will bring their pets must also bring with them vaccination documents of their pets and metal cages.
Sabi daw nila na wala daw ako ng bakante, ano daw sa 27. Kasi dito lang ako, kaya wala ako pag-uwian dito sa Juan, sa Manila.
Hindi pa ako sigurado kung makapamasko pa po sa amin. Kasi hindi ko pa sure kung bukas na ba ang alis ko. Yung panahon, saka oras, siyempre, yun ang pinakahinayang ko sa akin eh. Mahirap talaga pag ma-delete ang imuhang biyahe.
Carmina, according to Samonte, there is a slim chance that those who do not have a ticket yet will be able to purchase one. She requested Marina or the Maritime Industry Authority and the shipping lines to add ships. Carmina?
All right, Victoria, I just noticed in your report that most of the people there at the port, they're not wearing masks.
That's correct, Carmina. Most people here are not wearing masks, and the PPA recently, or today this morning, said that they are encouraging people to wear masks to avoid being infected with COVID.
All right. Victoria, if I don't see you here at HQ, I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. And really, thanks for joining our family. Really appreciate all the work that you've been doing. A provincial bus operators group assuring the public there are enough buses, even as it sees a steady increase in travelers due to the holidays. The group also urged the public to take this safety measure amid the Christmas rush.
Yung panawagan namin sa mga kababayan natin na sumakay sila doon sa main terminal. Doon sa mga main terminal ng bus, sa Cubao, sa Avenida, yung iba sa PITX, yung mga ibang mga terminal na sa Monumento, Pasay. So, kasi doon sa main terminal, meron na sapat yung ating seguridad doon. Meron tayong mga check doon ng mga security guard.
Oil companies playing the Grinch this Christmas. They're set to implement a big-time oil price hike next week. Gasoline and diesel might increase by as much as 1 peso and 60 centavos per liter. Kerosene also seen to go up by a peso and 80 centavos. The Philippine Energy Department cites ongoing global tensions for the hike.
Ang kadahilanan po, yung kaguluhan or iniiwasan po kasi nila yung pagdaan sa Red Sea ng mga oil companies tsaka mga tankers owner kasi parang nagkakaroon po ng attack on commercial vessels dito sa Red Sea ng mga Yemen Southeast Rebel. So nagtatakot po yung mga ating mga world top shipping oil companies tsaka yung mga oil giants. So dahil po sa pangyayaring ito, nagkakaroon pa ng reroute ng vessels. So kung magre-reroute, may additional cost yun kasi mas mahaba yung dadaanin nila.
Aside from pump prices, cooking gas also projected to increase. The price of a regular LPG tank could be 38 pesos higher soon due to a rise in freight costs.